Hi, it's Evangeline from eTrailer.com, and today we are looking at our Thule Helium 2 bike platform rack here on our 2020 Hyundai Palisade. Now, this is an awesome bike rack if you're looking for something light and effortless to install and uninstall, mount and dismount your bike racks. Like, especially for me, because I might have noodle arms, so it's kind of hard for me to lift heavy bike racks by myself and install them. This was super easy to install. Now, if you want to access the hatch of your Palisade, this does tilt away. So to do so, you just pull the lever here at the end. There it is. And then it tilts down. It stops itself right there. And then you can access your hatch. Let's see if there's clearance. Yep, there's so much clearance between there, so that's awesome because then you can just reach in, put your groceries away, take things out with no problem at all, and not having to worry about if your door will come in contact with your bike. So no problem there. And to lift it back up, you just lift and it snaps back into place. So the way our bike here is mounted to our bike rack is by these two wheel mounts. So that's great because it's a wheel mount, so you don't have to worry about warping the frame of your carbon fiber bike. And to dismount your bike, all you need to do is press that lever and pull that back. Press it right there and pull that back. And we have this platform here, which you can slide, so that's great because then you can adjust where you want your bikes to be and then they're not banging into each other. So with this here, we just lift the bike up and out of the way and you're ready to go on your bike ride very quickly. So to put it back, all you need to do is just ratchet it back into place, just like that. I told you it was easy. And just push it into place. And that's a nice way to have it when you're just ready to go out and about. Let's measure the length of this bike rack on the back of our vehicle here. So the length added to the end is 28 inches. So that's a good amount of length. Just something to keep in mind when you are backing into your garage or parking into a tight space. As for ground clearance, with it in this position, on the back at the end is 16.5 inches. Now let's lift it up. To lift it up, all you need to do is press that lever and it folds up against your vehicle. So the length added to our vehicle here is from our back bumper again to the back is 10.5 inches, and to this knob it is 13 inches. So for ground clearance, now this knob is here to protect, or it'll be the first thing that will hit the ground if you do go up a steep driveway, and it is 11.5 inches. So that's your ground clearance here on our Palisade. Now let's take a look here at the way it is attached to our hitch. So this fits 1.25 inch and 2 inch wide hitch receivers. So it's right now it's in our 2 inch hitch on our Palisade, and you just pop that in there and you tighten it over here. So this is the anti-rattle mechanism, and it extends and causes it to really sink into that hitch. I'm trying to shake this as hard as I can and it's not moving at all. So with that tightened, you can then lock it right here and you can protect your bike rack. So the closest it comes to our Palisade here from the back bumper to the end of these wheel mounts is 3 inches. So that's kind of close, but if I do a shake test, it's not coming any closer than that. So that's fine. All right. So final thoughts about this bike rack is I love how it looks. It looks super sleek. I like this nice aluminum style. It looks great against our car here, which I'm a big fan of. And it's also very sturdy, and it's very effortless to mount and dismount, install and uninstall. It's light, and I love that a lot. So that was a look at our Thule Helium 2 bike platform rack here on our 2020 Hyundai Palisade.
Here on our test course, we'll start by going through the slalom. This is going to show us the side-to-side action. This simulates turning corners or evasively maneuvering. Once we get to the alternating speed bumps, we'll see the twisting action. This will simulate hitting a curb or a pothole, or driving over uneven pavement. Once we get to the full speed bumps, we'll see the up and down action. This will be just like driving in and out of a parking lot, parking garage, or driveway.